Hi, I'm Seraphim. If you've watched any of my previous videos, you may come to find that the common thread that's woven throughout is all about how to bring more magic into your life. That is what I'm all about. There is literally magic all around us. Most people aren't necessarily tuned into it or just aren't aware of it. We're too busy going about our regular day. So today I wanted to offer just a few ways that you can tune into the conversation with your guides, your higher selves, the universe, source, however you perceive that, so you can tap into this magic anytime you please. It is literally always there for you. The other piece of this is spirit is, as I said, always communicating with us. Some are more open to receiving those messages than others. That said, spirit's clever. So even for those who may not necessarily be tuned into the conversation, typically the universe is going to find a way to get that message across. Regardless, there are some very common ways spirit does tend to communicate with us, even though it does tend to be quite specific. So I'm going to give you 6 indicators today. And if you're noticing any of these 6 things, I strongly recommend that you pause and take a moment to just reflect on what message or what information it is spirit may be trying to convey to you in that moment. So if you want to start developing the conversation with your guides, with your higher selves, and really just participating in the magic of the universe, this video is the one for you. Welcome to the Empowered Empath. When you're learning to listen to spirit and you've chosen to participate in the conversation with your higher selves and source and the universe, the most important thing to remember is that spirit is going to communicate in ways that are meaningful to you, specifically to you. So what this means is pay attention to the coincidences that have meaning for you. Now, full disclosure here, I don't believe in coincidence. Where most people see coincidence, I believe in synchronicity. But undoubtedly, you've had moments that feel like magical coincidence. So a quick example, let's say you have this song from your childhood, and it's a really obscure song. You're one of the few people who's even really familiar with that song. And suddenly you start hearing it in strange places, like it's on the radio, or you go into work and someone's playing this song. Maybe you're walking through the supermarket and you hear this song. But over and over again, this song keeps coming up. And it's not a song, as I said, that most people are familiar with. So for you, it has specific meaning. It's a song you're familiar with. Maybe it's from your childhood and you're noticing it. And it seems strange to you. You're probably going, well, that's weird. Like I never hear this song and all of a sudden it's like everywhere. Weird. This is where I recommend that you pause. Now, only you can really feel out what the truth of that message is in the experience for you. And this starts by asking yourself some insightful questions about whatever it is that you're noticing. So with a song, for instance, what are the lyrics? Do the lyrics to that song have any relevance to you or your current situation? Or is it taking you back to a memory? Does the memory that's associated with that song have relevance for what's going on in your life now? What about feelings? Do you associate that song with particular emotions or particular feelings? Where the message lay in the experience, that's where the specificity, that's where the message that is specific to you is coming in. So when you're noticing these magical coincidences, this is where I recommend that you pause. Now I'm going to go through 6 of these instances where you may notice these magical coincidences. I'm just going to call them synchronicities going forward in this video. But when you're noticing these 6 things, pause and start asking yourself some questions. Start reflecting on what exactly is the message for you. Number 1. The first one I already kind of mentioned, and that has to do with music. So spirit is going to use music that is meaningful to us to convey certain messages. And as I said before, it's important to listen to the lyrics of that particular song. Is it the lyrics that have a message for us? Is it associated with a memory that has relevance to what's going on in our lives right now? Or maybe we were with a certain person the very first time we heard that song, and it always kind of brings us back to that memory. Maybe it has something to do with that person. So you really want to feel into where the message is for you in particular. But music is definitely a very common one that spirit will use. Music is connected closely to our memory and emotion centers. So it's no surprise, spirit's going to use something that's going to move us energetically to get our attention. So this is partially why music is such a common conduit for communication with spirit. Number two, words or phrases that seem to be repeated to you in a short period of time. So maybe you see a particular phrase or saying on your Facebook, and then you're driving to work and you see a billboard that has either the same saying or something that's very close to that saying. And then you get to work and you're in conversation with a coworker and they say that phrase to you. So if you're noticing a lot of the same saying, phrase, or particular structure of words, this is something to pay attention to. Spirit will use all manner of people, things. It uses the internet, our Facebook, our Instagram, the people in our lives, animals, which I will get to a little later. But there's all means of communication spirit's going to use to get your attention. So particular phrases that keep coming back into your awareness to the point where you're noticing it and you're thinking, weird coincidence. Again, no such thing as coincidence. So pay attention, and really, what is the relevance? That's the most important question that you want to ask yourself, is what is the relevance here for me specifically in my current situation? Number three, animals. This is easily one of my favorite ways that spirit will communicate with us, but essentially, what I'm getting at is if you are seeing a lot of the same type of animal in various different places, and I'll give you an example, hummingbirds. I was writing a story and I used hummingbird as a nickname for one of my characters. Then I started seeing hummingbirds everywhere. I bought a card for someone and flipped it over, and the logo on the back of the card was a hummingbird. I was seeing hummingbirds outside my window, not something that I'm used to seeing in the area where I was at that time. But hummingbirds, when I looked into the meaning of hummingbirds, I had no idea that they were associated with rebirth, with death and rebirth. And this was largely a theme in the story that I was writing at that time. So for me, it had incredible meaning. It was also a transformation I was going through in my own life. Huge changes where I felt like everything that once was laid to rest, and I was starting to build something new on the rubble of my previous life. So the message of the hummingbird for me was incredibly encouraging, and one saying that rebirth is not only possible, but a beautiful process. So what is the meaning of that animal for you? Now, in doing this, I recommend asking yourself, what feelings do you associate with the animal? But also do a little bit of research. So what are the traits of that animal? What are the characteristics of that animal? And what is the symbolism that's typically associated with that animal? And how does that apply to your current situation? I'm always going to bring it back into the current, because that is where the relevance lay. So for me, I was able to find where the relevance was in my hummingbirds fairly easily. Death and rebirth was a huge theme for me at that time. It may be more subtle, but certainly I would say tease that out. And again, use your intuition to determine what is true. And I mentioned before, you may be seeing the animals in person. You may see a video of that animal online. You may get a card that has a picture of that animal. You may look at a comic and there's that particular animal in the comic. It's not necessarily about where you're seeing it, but that you're seeing it in various different places in a short span of time. And it's the same type of animal, which is an unusual thing for you to be noticing. Number four, dreams. This one probably seems pretty obvious, right? But not everybody remembers their dreams. So my belief is spirit is always communicating with us, and dreams, the dreamscape, is where we can do a lot of spiritual work. You may not necessarily remember those dreams or remember exactly what it is that you're doing in the dreamscape, but if you are someone who remembers your dreams, spirit will communicate with the waking self this way also. You know what I'm going to tell you. Write your dreams down. Yeah, you've heard this a million times because dreams slip away. Dreams are so easy to forget. They are connected to our subconscious. They're connected to the astral and the etheric, and they have a different texture and just a different form of memory. And it seems they're so easily forgotten. That's why I say they slip away. So write your dreams down. This will solidify the memory of that dream and will help you to remember certain details. As you're writing it down, you may have other details come forward, so you can jot those down as well. It may be surprising to you which details are important. Colors, sounds, smells, all of these things you want to note when you're writing your dream down. Dreams are very symbolic quite often, so it is important to look at the symbolism in your dream. You can Google anything now, so if you have a particular symbol in your dream and you're like, weird, I have no idea what that means, Google it and find what resonates with you. If you're remembering your dreams, there's probably a reason. There's something for you in that. And if nothing else, you're going to get to know yourself better. And that's the other thing that I'm all about, is coming to know yourself more deeply. So you can't go wrong. But dreams are a huge conduit for communication with spirit. Definitely one that I recommend that you engage in if you are blessed to remember your dreams. Number 5, repeating number sequences. This one is super, super common for those who are starting their journey of awakening, or really throughout the process of awakening. And probably the most common one is 1111. So you've probably seen this referenced online. You may be noticing 1111 in various places in your own life, but it's not just 1111. It's not confined to simply that number. You may be seeing 555, 999, 333. You may have a number sequence that's specific to you. For a long time, I was seeing 747 everywhere I looked. I would always look at the clock at 747 a.m., p.m. On receipts, I would buy things and the total would be 747. Just in the most random places, I was seeing this number. I didn't really know what it meant at the time, but it was enough that I was thinking, man, this is so weird. It's like this number is following me. When I looked into the number and I realized what the meaning behind it was, I was like, oh, okay, I get it. All right, spirit, I hear you. Now I don't see that number anymore. I received the message, I integrated the message, and now I see different numbers. But I always have a good sense of what it is that message is for me, what it is spirit is trying to convey through that message. And when I see these number sequences now, there's a real sense of comfort and joy that comes with that. I know that spirit is there with me, spirit is communicating with me, and it's a beautiful reassurance. So number sequences are often referred to as angel numbers. If you are participating in the spiritual community, then you may have heard this phrase. It's likely something that you will hear if you haven't yet. I'm going to link to a resource site. It's not one that I am affiliated with, but I do find it to be a very useful resource when trying to determine what exactly it is that these angel numbers mean or what message they may be carrying for me at any given time. So I'm going to link to that in the description below. That said, if you would like to see me do a video on specific number sequences, like 1111, for instance, what does that mean? Why do you keep seeing 1111? Or 555, why do you keep seeing 555? Then give me a like or write me a comment and just let me know. I want to make sure that the videos I'm making are relevant and useful to you. So if that's something that you want to see in the future, then show me a little love. Number 6. This one may actually surprise you. But number 6 has to do with the people who are either entering your life or exiting your life. You may have a time in your life where it seems like a lot of people are exiting your life, and it's like, You don't really know why or what's going on or what's changed. Or you may have a time in your life where you have several new people entering your life. This is where discernment of the message is incredibly important. If people are leaving your life, what is the quality of that relationship to you? Are you losing relationships that bring a lot of value in your life? Why is it that that may be happening? It's really important to go into the reasons why, how, if these are relationships that are adding value to your life. The message may have to do with some changes that you need to make in your form of relating or communication. If these people who are leaving your life maybe aren't bringing as much value or aren't helping to bolster your sense of self or your growth, this may be a positive shift that's taking place. So honesty, number one, is the most important thing with number six, with discerning whether or not this is a positive or a negative, these people exiting your life. If new people are coming into your life, what is the quality of the people coming into your life? Are they now adding value? Did some people leave your life to make room for some of these other people entering your life? Is it your vibration which has changed? And is it an affirmative change? Or is it one that you want to tweak a little bit so that you're able to bring more value into your life and your relationships? But typically when we have a lot of change in terms of the people in our lives, it tends to be an auspicious time or an important time in our lives. And it's a good idea to take a look at what messages may be coming in simply by nature of the changing faces in our life. This one is a little bit more subtle as well, but spirit will work through us. We may not even realize sometimes how or when spirit is using us as a vessel to either provide a message or convey a concept. So keep that in mind. Communicating with spirit is a conversation with your guides, your higher self, and with the universe. I know I've said this before, but this is a conversation that should be fun and remind you of the magic that is literally in every single day and is all around you. Spirit is always communicating with us. We just have to tap into that information and that communication. I'm telling you, there is nothing more thrilling than asking a question and receiving an answer in a way that makes sense to you, and recognizing that you are participating in that conversation. It is affirmation of the fact that there is magic in the world, and affirmation of the fact that you are part of that magic and an important, valued part. Spirit is with all of us and wants all of us to move into our highest and best good. Spirituality is not all about quiet meditation and heart-to-heart conversations. While I love those aspects, it's also about running barefoot and swimming in a creek or eating fruit off of a tree and recognizing the incredible magic in these experiences. Being here is incredible, and cultivating this conversation can help remind you just how incredible and amazing it is that we get to be here and have this physical experience. So I hope that these six aspects will help you to recognize when it's a good idea to pause and ask yourself, is there a message here for me? Is spirit communicating with me? Or what is the relevance in my life right now for these coincidences? I hope this video helps you to cultivate your own conversation with spirit, and would really love to hear what experiences you may have had or how spirit has communicated with you in the past. So if you're so inclined, please do share in the comments below. Otherwise, I just want to say thank you again for watching. I very much appreciate your viewership. And if you find this video helpful, please like and share with your friends. If you'd like to subscribe, don't forget to hit the bell so that you're notified whenever I post a new video. You can also visit tarotbyseraphim.ca if you'd like to learn more about my practice or to book a personalized session with me. And to join the Empowered Empath Facebook group, you want to visit Tarot by Seraphim on Facebook. But I will link to all that good stuff in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. Blessings, and I shall see you next week. Take care for now, my empaths.